Welcome to New York's number two sports show. The Rangers have a five-game winning streak, and Igor Shesterkin gets his first shutout of the season. The Rangers beat the Calgary Flames 2-0 at MSG, and February has definitely been a lot kinder to the Rangers. And this five-game winning streak dates back to even before the All-Star break. They had that win versus Ottawa, and then they've reeled off four straight: Colorado, Tampa, Chicago, and Calgary coming out of that break. But Shesterkin, it was a great goalie matchup. Shesterkin, who, as we know, has generally struggled lately. I thought he really was better versus Chicago, but the results really maybe weren't there for him, but he got the win. Jacob Markstrom has been really good for Calgary, and tonight he was as well. Markstrom did everything he could to give his team a chance to win, but Igor was just a little bit better. And the second Ranger goal was an empty net goal. So it was one goal by Will Cuylle in the second period that was the difference. The Rangers, they are so much better when, you know, they're playing a better defensive brand of hockey. Of course, it helps when you're getting good goaltending, but that's going to be the recipe for success for the Rangers, is winning these low-scoring games and playing in games that don't have a whole lot of goal scoring. That's what they were doing earlier in the season. And I thought the Rangers really came out strong, had a good first period. I thought the Rangers for the first half of this game were clearly the better team. They may have taken their foot off the gas slightly, and it kind of reminded me, I believe they kind of did the same thing against Calgary earlier in the season in Calgary in the third period, where that was a 3-1 win. And Igor played pretty well in that game too. But, you know, so these games were a little bit similar, although Markstrom, you know, is much better at this point than he was earlier in the season. And Calgary, they've been playing better lately. They were coming in on, I believe, either a 3 or possibly 4-game winning streak. I know that they had beaten the Devils and Islanders on the local trip, on the tri-state trip. But the Rangers were not going to let them leave having won all of those games. There was a lineup change and involved the forward group. So the Rangers called up a couple of forwards. Adam Edstrom, who had played one game earlier in the season versus the Ducks and actually scored in that game late. And Matt Rempe was also recalled. He did not play. He did take part in pregame warmups, and they gave him like the rookie lap, but he didn't play. We'll see if he gets in the lineup. But more of note, and well, first I'll say less of note, Jake Lecision was sent down. He had been up as kind of that extra forward, that 13th forward, so kind of inconsequential. But Tyler Pitlick, who has basically been a regular lineup, I mean, of course, there were times where he was a healthy scratch, but Pitlick, who really has not done a whole lot lately, he was a healthy scratch, and I think that that will continue. I think that Edstrom will, for now, get the nod over Pitlick. So, I don't know. Like, as far as Pitlick's future with the team, you know, knowing that they got rid of Bonino a few weeks ago, like, look, Pitlick could be in a similar situation. I did like what he was doing for a while, even though, like, he wasn't really doing much offensively. I thought that he was fine, if nothing else, but to be honest, yeah, lately he has not really been great. If anything, I've kind of noticed him more on the negative side. So I have no problem with Edstrom getting a look. I'm not sure if Rempe will, but so that fourth line was Goodrow centering VZ and Edstrom. The Rangers also tried some new power play units, which by the end, they were basically scrapped, although really none of the power plays worked. The Rangers were 0-for-3. That power play continues to struggle. That's kind of the amazing thing, is that the Rangers have not scored a power play goal in a while, and yet they've won games. So that's encouraging, because that's really a big part of the Rangers' success. And I think that they will get going again, but what they tried to do was, one of the units was the Zibanejad line with Kreider and Wheeler, plus it had Brodzinski and Fox. And the other power play unit was the Trocheck line with Panarin and Lafreniere, with Kako and Gustafsson. And they tried that for the first couple of power plays, but then by the time the third period hit and they were up 1-0, they went back to the original that we've been accustomed to, and that one didn't look good either. So I'm not sure what they'll do heading into next game, but that was another topic of conversation. So Calgary Flames at the New York Rangers. Like I said, Rangers, you know, get off to what I thought was a pretty good start. But you could tell Igor was locked in. Like, it was one of those things where Igor didn't look uncomfortable. He looked confident. He, you know, the rebound control was good. He was making glove saves, which is important because that's really been his weakness this season. So I thought he, beyond the results, he just looked good. First period, there were some penalties. Killington interferes with Will Cuylle, and Cuylle was very active. You know, beyond the goal he scored, I thought Cuylle had a really good game. Rangers probably doesn't score there. Then at 12:28, matching minors to Cuylle and Pospisil. And that was – so there was 4-on-4 for a little bit, but we lead the first period with no scoring. Second period at 8:51, there is and I guess I should say just in terms of game flow, I really feel like the Rangers that first period, I thought the Rangers were the better team. And then for a lot of the second period too, in the second, you get a situation where there's an after-the-whistle scrum. And the Rangers end up shorthanded coming out of this. Gustafsson, Panarin, and Panarin threw a punch in there. But Gustafsson, Panarin, and Lafreniere are all called for penalties. And Pospisil and Pahal were called for Calgary. But only, what, less than 20 seconds into the Calgary power play, Huberdeau trips Trouba. So then it's 4-on-4, and there's no scoring there. And eventually, at 12:31, Will Cuylle scores his ninth goal of the season from Kako and Brodzinski. So this line's actually been pretty good. All the way around, it's been solid. And I don't think, I guess when I look at it with Brodzinski, he really has been like pretty damn good. And it's kind of amazing. Like, he's been in the Rangers. He's been with the Ranger organization now for 4 seasons. Most of the first couple were with Hartford. And this was someone that already was somewhat of a journeyman. You know, I think he came up in the Kings organization and he was with the Sharks for a little bit. And he's kind of found a home with the Rangers. But it's not really until this season that he's gotten like a real look. And that was really due to the Philip Hedl injury. That's given him this opportunity to essentially be the third line center. And he's done a pretty good job with it, to the point where I think that the Rangers will definitely try to acquire a third line center. But Brodzinski's been good enough to the point where maybe you're not in a total desperate situation. And I would almost think that even if he moves off of that third line center, I wouldn't automatically scratch him. Like, I think he could have a role on the fourth line, but maybe he's also better suited for center. The point is this, like, when it comes to just even strength centers, like, give me Brodzinski over Goodrow, which really isn't much of a surprise at this point. I don't even think that's really much of a shocking statement. I mean, when it comes to penalty kill and different things like that, that's a different story. But anyway, I want to give Brodzinski a little bit of love because, I think he's got like 4 goals and 10 assists and maybe 30 plus or so games. So like the stats are actually pretty good. But as far as this play goes, it was more Kako and Cuylle. Kako does a good job of driving to the net. And that's what he has to do. He takes a shot. It's stopped by Markstrom. Then Cuylle just keeps on whacking away, which you don't see that many Rangers do. That's what I like about him. He's different than the mold that we've seen, either, you know, young players or veterans. That's what's impressive about him. So I really continue to say that I think his future is pretty bright. He is still, he just turned 22. So it's been a really good rookie year for him. He's got 9 goals. He's a +4 in 53 games. So he's played in each game. So he's been durable. And I just like what he brings to the table. And he's only going to get better. So, you know, as bad as the Elias Anderson pick was, at least trading Anderson to the Kings turned into Will Cuylle. So at least not all was lost in what was a just dreadful draft pick. So the Rangers take a 1-0 lead there. Then unfortunately, Kako does take a tripping penalty soon after the goal at 13:01. But the Rangers penalty kill does the job, kills it off. And the Rangers take a 1-0 lead going into the third. And I'm thinking, will Igor? I mean, you're hoping for the win first off, but will he finally get a shutout? You know, he hasn't had one all season. It's been tough for him to find. And in the third, I thought the Rangers sat back a little bit. I was concerned. They did get a power play, and Blake Wheeler had a nice sequence defensively after Kreider kind of made a risky pass cross ice. Wheeler made a nice play, gets out of the zone, and he's hooked by Pichal. But the Rangers probably does not score. So with 5 minutes left, you're thinking, all right, Calgary might tie this up. They had a lot of chances. They eventually pull the goalie, Markstrom, and Igor took a shot at the empty net, which was risky. It ends up being an icing. He probably, you know, it was exciting to see him try, and I hope in his career he does get an empty net goal, but there, yeah, maybe not the spot you're looking for. Eventually, the Rangers do seal it on an empty net goal by Jimmy Vesey, his 12th goal of the season. I got to think that at least like three or four of his goals are empty net, at least three. But it was a nice play. He is able to have Noah Hanifin turn the puck over, and so he retrieves it, fires it into the empty net on kind of a somewhat of a tough angle with Hanifin still defending. So it was a pretty nice empty net goal for Vesey. It's kind of amazing, you know, and we'll talk highly of him. He's just totally redefined his game. Like his first three seasons, his first in as a Ranger, like there was a lot of hope, a lot of promise. I mean, like very much so. And he didn't live up to it. And, you know, he left the Rangers traded him away and he bounced around quite a bit. And then he comes back last season, and I think it's before he got here. Like, I guess I'd say the season before with the Devils, even though that wasn't a good New Jersey team, I think Vesey, specifically that season, was able to find, like, a bottom six sort of role and kill penalties, and because that wasn't part of his game at all. He was really not good defensively. So that was the problem. Like, he wasn't providing enough offense, and he was a bit of a defensive liability. So it's credit to him for sticking with it. A lot of those players, like, they just fizzle out, and you don't really hear from them again. But now he comes back to the Rangers and is an absolute staple on that fourth line. And if you ever needed him to, he could move up in the lineup. So, yeah, and they haven't been on a bargain. I think his cap hit is... it's less than a million. I think it might be maybe 800K, something like that. So that's a really good for him and really good for the Rangers. So Rangers win 2-0. Igor is the story of the game. The Rangers record now sits at 34-16-3. 5-game winning streak. They're 18-7 at home. So that home record, that's a really good one. And they're 6 points ahead of the Hurricanes, and Carolina has 2 games in hand. So that's still a close race. But, you know, especially with Carolina playing good hockey of late, the Rangers are holding them off for now. So the Rangers' next game will be Thursday, home against the Montreal Canadiens. Now, they played earlier in the year, about a little more than a month ago, at Montreal. Montreal won that game in a shootout. And that was a bit of a wacky game. Sam Monsonbeau was really good in net for Montreal. The Rangers came back, could have very well won, but only got the point. But obviously, you know, this is a winnable game for the Rangers. I feel like, weirdly, when I think back to recent seasons, the Rangers have, and I don't have, like, the official stats to back it up, but I think that Montreal's kind of had the Rangers' number a little bit at MSG the last few years, considering the fact that Montreal has not been a great team. And this will be the first of 2 meetings at MSG, the second one later on in the season. So we'll see what happens. And I guess a little concern for this game is, A, Rangers have had a 5-game winning streak, and they're going to face a Montreal team that, you know, again, is not in the playoff hunt at all. And you have this, you know, outdoor game, you know, Sunday the 18th at MetLife Stadium versus the Islanders. So I think the concern with me, and they got to just stick with it, is to not look ahead, and especially with the success they've already had. So you might have a bit of, I guess you'd call it a trap game, possibly. As far as Shesterkin versus Quick, who plays, I think it's going to be Igor, right? He's coming off the shutout. The only reason why there's any hesitation for me is because I think it's a lock that he is going to be playing in that MetLife outdoor game. And so with that, Quick will then have not played for quite some time. What I can guarantee you is that Quick will be playing. That game against Dallas on the 20th. Will definitely be Jonathan Quick, regardless of anything. And the question is, who plays against Montreal? I think that they will just roll with Igor because, you know, he's starting to find his game. You don't want to ruin that now. So That's probably what it'll be, but not definitely. Anyway, Rangers five-game winning streak. Shesterkin's first shutout of the season. Rangers defeat the Calgary Flames 2-0.